Since ancient times, our universe was ruled by two groups of mystical and powerful creatures. These beings are known as the Highest and the Demons. While the Highest were full-fledged creators of planets, dimensions, and the life that inhabits them, the task of demons was to regulate the balance of the good and bad sides of living beings. To have various points of inconsistency, wars, and complication of the lives of the said planet's inhabitants. Though, the Highest perceived demons as condescending, but an open war with them would mean that the Highest would have had to do all the dirty work themselves, which was below their dignity. Therefore, an agreement was signed. The Highest won't attack the demons while they fulfill their part of the work. In addition, demons have the right to release their wildest desires if it does not result in the existence of the Highest and demons to the mortals. For a long time after that, the demons and Highest lived peacefully. However, one day, everything changed. Demons are divided into three main categories. Demons of Sharpness, Wave Demons, and Demons of Gap. This is Negagen, a Wave Demon. Such demons characterize a reduced level of aggression. They dwell in hidden, lonely water forests. They love the water because most of the time, these demons are in a state of meditation through which they inhibit the absorbed souls. Water helps them to keep calm. These demons have weak spectrum of emotions and tend to avoid encounters with other demons. Wave demons are occasionally prone to capture a developing soul, but usually capturing the souls of small animals. But this time, near from the place where Negagen meditated, there was a large group of Mobians. Negagen got closer and one by one, quietly took the souls of all members of the group. Such a large number of new developed souls caused the demon to spend a lot of strength to keep them inside. Unfortunately for Negagen, the other wave demons that were in the area also sensed the group of Mobians, and while Negagen tried to calm the enraged souls, they found him.
Look at that. Seems like Negagen took more souls than he can handle. He didn't even think to leave any for us. Perhaps he should be taught a lesson for such insolence.
Negagen tried to assist, but the soul's pressure weakened him from the inside. When the enemy demon prepared to suck all the souls out of Negagen, and at the same time kill him, suddenly, from the side, something black flashed and the other waver flew off to the side, unconscious. Near to Negagen stood a black cloak-shaped figure with red stripes on his winged thorns. Negagen realized that it was Demon of Sharpness before him, but he felt weird. Usually Demons of Sharpness behave extremely aggressively, killing all that they see. The Demons of Sharpness are the most active, most physically strong, and militant demons. They like to steal lonely mortals and torture and eventually kill them. They call it a game. In ordinary circumstances, meeting with the Sharper meant certain death, but the demon who decided to knock out the other waver felt much more relaxed. Looking at Negagen, the figure said,
"You don't need to absorb souls."
"What?"
"Control the vessels with their souls. You will save a lot of energy."
"Wait. What did he mean?"
Negagen came to the place where he left the bodies of the Mobians. The demon began to carefully return the souls to their owners while still keeping them under control. Soon the Mobians got to their feet. Negagen was surprised to find out that they were completely under his control, but their souls no longer resisted much. Meanwhile, the enemy waver woke up.
"Ha! You decided to return with the souls of the living and give them to me so that I'll let you live? Huh. Well, you're going to die anyway.
The enemy began to attack Negagen. Our demon has ordered the spawn souls to attack the enemy. They quickly obeyed. Wei was surprised and tried to kill the inhabitants, but Negagen was smarter. He only made them attack when they had the chance. Soon, the joint efforts of Negagen and the souls, the demon was defeated. But then Negagen thought, who was this mysterious sharper? Why didn't he kill him? Why he felt that mighty? After thinking about it, our wave demon decided to find this demon. Negagen went on a long adventure. Later, he learned that some pious named Exetior was prowling among demons and sought allies for some business. It turns out that it was he who helped Negagen.
Did a highest just help me?
Reflecting on this, our wave demon continued his quest along the way, gaining himself a small army of new souls of different creatures. After months of wandering, he finally got on Exetior's trail. When the desired demon had been found, the unexpected happened. Negagen was nearby when he heard the sounds of battle. Coming closer, he saw a few dozen sharpers who attacked the highest demon. Also, there was the demons of Gap, which was ruled by their own subordinates and incited them to Exetior. It was very unusual. Shapers were never known for good teamwork, but to ally with the demons of Gap? Also, it was strange that there was more than one demon of Gap, as these demons tend to always work alone. Seems that something very serious had happened, since they decided to work together. Negagen understood that he is the most weak among all these demons, but he could not bring himself to leave the one who once saved his own life. Negagen spread part of his army to distract the demons of Gap, and together with the rest of the army rushed to the aid of Exetior. Things turned out really serious. Negagen was able to distract most of the enemy demons to himself so Exetior could leave. But his own army began to become overwhelmed. Along with this, he himself began to lose strength. Several enemy demons attacked Negagen, and he realized that he couldn't make it. Soon, Negagen lost consciousness. When Negagen woke up, he saw that he was lying somewhere in the forest. He no longer felt a single soul under his control. Looking around, he saw the highest demon, who sat on the side of him, and restored his power. Seeing that Negagen woke up, he smiled a little.
Are you awake already? Good. You were badly hurt back there. Don't know how you found me or why, but thank you. Without you, I would have had to expose myself.
You saved me before. I could not leave you to die.
Die? Funny. So, why were you looking for me?
I wanted to thank you for the advice with souls, but later I discovered you're a highest. But why do you look like a demon?
This is a disguise. I need to find out more about Mobius and its inhabitants, and to contact some demons.
Can I help you?
You helped me before, and I will admit, you have been a great help, but you're a pretty weak demon. I would want you to get killed by getting yourself wrapped up in my affairs. You'd better go and live a quiet, meditative life like you used to.
I want to help.
Suddenly, Exetior was silent.
As much as I would like to discuss this more with you, soon there will be reinforcements of the group from which we just deal with. We gotta go.
Our demons quickly fled, along the way, talking among themselves. Exetior allowed Negagen to travel with him if he would obey the Highest. Soon the demon and the Highest became good friends. Exetior liked the obedience and potential of the Waver, and Negagen admired the strength and wisdom of Exetior. Negagen still didn't know much about his new friend, but he believed him. But after a year, the war started between the Highest and demons. The truce was broken. The demons, headed by Exetior, fought for the independence of Mobius from Erasure. Highest perceived living beings and the entire evolution of development of them as a simple game, unworthy of any special attention. Exetior was lost in that war. Ironically, he was turned into a demon of sharpness, who he used to pretend to be. He was then sent to prison. Many of the demons were sent to be tortured or just be killed. Negagen was exiled for life in prison and solitude. He spent several thousand years there, all alone. But one day, a strange portal appeared. Going through it, Negagen saw Exetior.
Master, you're alive.
Exetior told Negagen about the incident with which he got out of his prison and hid in one of the Mobius' dimensions.
I will not give up so easily, my friends. We will raise an army again, and when we will take back what was ours, we will free Mobius from an endless series of erasure.
I'm always ready to help you, Master.
Then, Exetior held Negagen in his own dimension, where the planet Mobius has already been mostly demonized. Exetior's plan was that the Highest can't just erase the demons without using a special energy. Exetior wanted to demonize all mortals from Mobius, so demons of all dimensions can attack and overthrow the totalitarian power of the Highest. Exetior told Negagen that he needed a new form to make the demon's location harder to track. Negagen saw as in one of the dimensions of Mobius, Hedgehog, named Sonic, had fought with other demons in super form. So Negagen decided to shapeshift into this form for himself. The task of Negagen was to create his own demonization analog, and that would be less painful, immersing the soul of the victim in a sweet dream, and taking their body for his own needs.
Some person not wear any clothes except shoes, and some are fully dressed all the time.